Welcome to NarayaSai Technologies. This is Ramchandar. In the last two videos, I did talk about what is concrete method and what is abstract method and what is the syntax of abstract method. And also what is the main intention of the abstract method also I told you in the last video. What is that? Abstract method is mainly designed for providing the rules or specifications. So, and in the last video, I given example, general example I given, but I didn't talk about any technical example. Especially, this video is giving full-fledged information about abstract method, technical manner. Observe. The concept is abstract method, technical approach. Abstract method. The main intention of the abstract method is only one thing. What is that? Providing rules or specifications. Rules or specifications. So why Java provides specifications or why Java provides rules? What is the use of these rules? So to understand this concept, let me explain one real-time scenario. This is our Java application. This is our Java application. To store the data permanently, which is raises in our Java application, we required some persistent stores like file management system. Another one is what? Database management system. So to work with the file management system, we required one package like java.io. And as well as to work with the relational database management system, we required java.sql package. Here, my intention is, we want to store the data which is available in the Java application into databases. So here, let me take databases. This entire part related to database, relational database management system. Now we have a different databases we have in the market. One is Oracle, and one more database I'm taking here, that is MySQL, and one more database I'm taking here, that is DB2. Yes. Now cleanly observe. In our Java application, whatever the response we get and whatever the output we get, that output I want to store into databases, any one of the relational database like either Oracle or MySQL or DB2. Now observe here, Java application architecture is different from database server architecture. So Java application developing on top of what here? Java software. By using Java software, we are developing Java application. So database management system or databases are developing on top of what here? C languages. So here, if you want to store the data which is available in the Java application into the databases, the internal meaning here is Java application must and should be communicating with what here? C related application. So both the architectures are different. Simply we can say Java application and database architectures are what here? Different. If one architecture wants to communicating with the another architecture, definitely we required one communication channel. Here communication channel is nothing but simply I'm telling like logic. We required some logic. That logic is useful for making a communication between Java application to database. By using that communication, maybe we can able to place the data into the database. Whenever we require, we can retrieve, we can update, we can delete. According to our project requirement, we can do different operation on database, on top of the database server. Now, I told you like logic is very much mandatory to communicating with these two a different architecture. Assume that logic is given by Java. Logic is given by Java. If the logic is given by Java, what type of problem we need to face? Observe. Again, in the relational database management itself, one database architecture is different from another database. Oracle is different from Oracle architecture is different from MySQL. MySQL architecture is different from DB2. If all the architectures are same, why companies are maintaining these many types of databases servers in the real world? So definitely these architectures are what? Different. See, if you want to make a communication between Java application to Oracle architecture, we required some type of logic. So let me treat this logic as what here? Logic 1. If you want to make a communication between Java application to MySQL server, we required logic 1 is not suitable to MySQL. We required some different logic. What is that? Logic 2. And if you want to make a communication between Java application to DB3, logic 1 and 2 are not supported, then definitely we can go for what? Definitely logic. Here logic, and here is also what here? Logic. Definitely what we require? Different logic. Here logic 1, here logic 2, here logic 3. We required 3 logics. Now observe guys. If only one logic is sufficient to communicating with the databases, means sufficient. Okay, reasonable. But here how many logics must and should be developed by the Java software developer? 3 types of logic. The first problem is problem number 1. Java software. Here Java means what here? Java software. Java software must be provides. Java software must be provides. Multiple logics. Java software must and should be provides multiple logics. Now that is the first problem. And problem number 2. What is the problem number 2? If you want to make a communication between Java application to database, we require some logic. We need to develop that logic. If you want to develop that logic, definitely we must and should be have a knowledge on Java software architecture as well as what your database architecture. So Java software developer must be aware about both Java and DB architectures. Both Java and DB architectures. That is the second drawback. First drawback is one logic is not sufficient. We need to create multiple logics. We need to develop multiple logics. And second problem is, if you want to develop that logic, Java software developer must and should be aware about what here? Java architecture as well as what here? DB architecture. That is the two problems. And the next problem is problem number 3. What is the problem number 3? Observe. If any new database coming into the market, so lot of databases we have, Oracle, MySQL, DB2, MongoDB, PostgreSQL, Teradata. So like this we have lot of database we have. For example, any new database is coming into the market and ready to providing the services to the Java. Then is Java is willing to communicating with that database? Definitely what we required? Again some logic we required. Again required logic means what here? Again Java software must and should be developed what here? One new more logic. That means every time logic must and should be updated in the Java software. So one more example. Architecture problem. If any database architecture is changes, based on that architecture changes, again we need to change the logic. That means if any new database is coming into the market, we need to write some extra logic and a new logic. And any existing database architecture changes, again we need to update our logic itself. That means Java software frequently updated. We need to update. Now the problem number 4 is, so problem number 3 we can rewrite like this. Problem number 3 we can rewrite like this. Frequently we need to update frequently we need to update Java software. That is the problem. And problem number 4. See, according to any new database coming into the market and old database is architecture changes, finally that will be affected to what year? Java software. That means either directly or indirectly Java software is depends on what? Java software depends databases. Java software depends what here? Databases. These are the main 4 problems are facing by the Java software when if the logic is given by what here? Java software itself. Understand that? So here the conclusion of this video is, whenever we working with the main intention of the abstract method is providing what here? Rules or specifications. So what is the use of these rules or specification? To understand that concept, I'm introducing one real time scenario. That is, if Java wants to communicating with the databases, definitely we required some different logic. Why this architecture is different from database architectures? If you want to make a communication between one architecture to another architecture, definitely we required some logic. And again, these databases are different from one to another. So single logic is not suitable to communicating with all the databases. Definitely we need to write multiple logic. That is the first drawback related to Java. The second one is, if you want to develop the logic, Java software developer must and should be aware about what here? Both architectures. And the third one is, if any new database is coming into the market or existing database has been changes, based on that changes and based on new database coming into the market, we need to update our logics. We need to add new logic. That means frequently we need to update our Java software. That means directly or indirectly Java software depends upon what your database server. So what Java software telling? If we want to, we means what? If database wants to providing the services to Java application, database wants to provide the services. Providing services is nothing but what? Storing the information permanently. Whenever we required, reading. Otherwise, deleting. Otherwise, updating. These type of services wants to, database wants to provide the Java application. Java software is simply telling like, we are not providing any logic to you. Nothing but Java is not providing any logic to databases. Simply, these type of problems never faced by the Java software. Simply, Java software is telling to the database servers, if you want to providing the services to us, we are giving some money to you, but we are not giving logic. If you are trying to give the logic, we need to face what here? These type of problems. Then what happened? Now logic is not given by the Java. Now logic is given by the what here? Database server. If the logic is given by the database server, what happened? That issue we will see in the next video. I hope you enjoyed this example. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.